next, I'd like to introduce, and Jake is an educator and activist, member of Queer Rising, a grassroots organization that demands full equality for the LGBT community. He's going to be speaking to us a little bit about the situation in Iran as it relates to LGBT rights.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Chris. My name, again, is Jake Goodman. I'm a member of Queer Rising, and I want to say that I'm very honored to be here and to be invited by Iran 180 to talk about human rights situations in Iran. Excuse me. As it relates specifically to the lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender community, or the LGBT community in Iran. And just to get it off the table, do any of you remember when Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad spoke at Columbia University in 2007? Yeah? When he was confronted on his record of human rights violations against women and also people of the LGBT community, he responded, "But there are no gay people in Iran." And people in Iran, the Columbian University students laughed him out of the room because they knew and they understand that there are LGBT people in every race, in every religion, every ethnicity, every age demographic, and every country in the world. Iran is no exception. It was ludicrous, it was insulting, and it was also very scary because Ahmadinejad's word helped to give a window to the Iranian gay government's official position that everyone in Iran is heterosexual, and homosexuality is a violation of the supreme will of God. LGBT people do not exist, and therefore there do not need to be any human rights violations, human rights protections for them, because they don't exist. My goal here today is to simply paint a picture of what life in Iran must be like for an LGBT person. I could talk about examples of human rights violations which happen all the time. How, for an example, in 2007, a 13-year-old boy was falsely accused of rape, sodomy of three teenage boys and was executed. Of how so many political dissidents are falsely accused of homosexuality, are charged, tried, and executed or disappeared. And also how I could talk about how people try to get asylum away from Iran, except for the fact that they cannot because there are other countries with greater need. My goal today is to talk about the laws and let you know what laws affect LGBT people on a daily basis, because these laws in themselves are human rights violations. So first of all, in Iran, homosexuality is a crime that is punishable by imprisonment, capital punishment, and in some cases, execution. Transsexuality is legal in Iran if it is accompanied by a gender reassignment surgery. All sexual relations in Iran that occur outside of marriage, and of course that is traditional heterosexual marriage, are illegal. Now this is where it gets tricky, and pay attention. There is no distinction in Iran between consensual and non-consensual sodomy. This is important because homosexual relations that occur between consenting adults are a crime and do carry a maximum punishment of execution in Iran, but that's very seldomly implemented. However, if there is rape sodomy, it is most often punishable by death. So, listen up. A person basically may repent if you commit sodomy and you will not be executed. But if you, so technically Iran can say they do not execute people for homosexuality. They only execute people for rape. Lesbians, and the last thing I'll say about the laws is that lesbianism, it doesn't exist, but if you are caught in a sexual act as a lesbian, you will receive 100 lashes. Now, in contrast to Iran's claims, human rights activists say that between 4,000 and 6,000 people have been executed since 1979 due to crimes related to sexual preference and gender expression. Gay Iranians every day do not feel comfortable walking around on the streets holding hands. It is unsafe for them. They are stereotyped as being sex-obsessed, child molesters, rapists, and disease-ridden people, the same as I was when I was in Albany advocating for marriage equality in New York. Just to say, What I will say last is there is some encouragement. There is a civil rights movement for LGBT people in Iran. The first group was called Homan in 2001. There was an online LGBT group started called Rainbow. Now there's a group called the Iranian Railroad for Career Refugees. And finally, there's this amazing Facebook page right now called We Are Everywhere. As of this morning, there are 5,015 members. I suggest you look it up. So the real question, and what I'll leave here today, is what can we do to help? First, as Americans, we can start by confronting the hateful and slanderous language that we hear against LGBT people here every day, coming from politicians and religious leaders and our own friends and families. How can we have any credibility crying out against human rights violations there when we have them here? Second, we can learn more about what is happening in Iran. Every time we learn more about the violations, we need to comment about it on Facebook, on Twitter, to our friends and family. And third, we can contact the State Department of the United States, say it is not okay. Human rights, LGBT rights, our human rights are for everybody. We need to advocate for them. Thank you very much.